got to accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, latch on to the affirmative, don't mess with Mr. In-Between.
One of the things that's been going on here for a very long time is positive postcards. When we get together on our early out Fridays and discuss kids, if kids have made a substantial improvement or if a kid's just doing well at anything, the team or the grade level will just, you just buy the little 3x5 cards, put the stamp on it, and just write, great job, we just really appreciate what you've been doing, we've noticed the following, and just mail those home. And it can go to kids that are making improvements that are the lowest end or behavioral students or your highest end kids, and it's just a quick heads up of we appreciate you, we love you, we care for you, and I think they go a long ways. Every year you have parents that come in and say, thank you, that made my student's day, or we were grateful, we appreciate that. It takes no time, it's no effort to it. It's literally why you're doing your normal MTSS stuff. It's just something that goes around and you pick 10 or 12 a week and just send them out. So it's really easy and it lets everyone know you care. Just looked at all the surveys that we had from parent-teacher conferences and the students and the parents and identified some specific things that we were great at. Leadership team made some suggestions for us and said we'd like to do some school-wide type of rules instead of more individualized classroom settings, and so we've started working on more of a school-wide culture of rules and expectations and, you know, ways to share what we're trying to do. And so that's been one of the things we've looked at is accreditation data, school leadership team, and then taking that to teachers during advisory time and working through those things. A part of it's just getting to know everyone again. I mean, I know the staff well, and they're professional, and they're great, and, you know, couldn't be more grateful for them. Students, it's really just trying to get to know names and trying to, every day, 5 or 6 new names and who the students are, trying to get to every group and getting to know as you walk through lunch or do a loop around the field as they eat and get to know each kid. And the same thing, my assistant Amber, she goes through the high flyers list every week, and if kids have made improvements, brings them down, thanks them, hands them a candy bar, just recognizes them, and then we have a chance for teachers to refer students that have done something special. We bring them down as an administrative team and just tell them thank you, and we recognize their accomplishments. Hopefully, if we don't have a mandated agenda item for our SNAD, we're going to present it at our SNAD at the end of this quarter. So that's the plan, is to just present it and start to be aware of our comments in our classes and like what we're focusing on, and really like the whole idea that we're looking more at the process or the work and praising specific things that they're doing as part of the work rather than just general praise and just kind of moving and making praise part of the curriculum and the teaching. And you can see that every classroom that functions really, really well, that is an embedded part of the teacher's
regard.
I think everybody, you have to evaluate yourself. I think at times you get negative over time and you start to focus on things that, you know, are out of your control, and it just, if you can reevaluate yourself and know that the way that you approach things, you know, and if you're positive, the students feed off of that, and you see that in the classrooms that are successful, and you see the opposite in the classrooms that are struggling. So I just think that's kind of how I approach it, is just be aware again and start to make that a big part of your culture and your vision and what you're trying to accomplish in your classes. The front office, the counselors, the registrar, everybody in the building, and with your teachers, just, you know, starting to have a lot more positive interaction.
I don't mess with Mr. In Between. Conrad Peszkutski.